Hey, this is Dustin Bird, and I'm going to be singing for you today. I thought it'd be kind of interesting to go through my releases with you since basically the beginning of it all, and take you song by song and play my tunes for you. So the first song that I ever put out was called She Likes My Guitar, and that song was pretty weird for me. You know, it was my debut, it was my entry into the world of radio, and you know, traditionally you'd put something out that's super, I suppose, market friendly and radio feeling, but we didn't do that. We decided that we were going to put this one out because it felt good, and we knew that it wasn't going to be a major kind of release, so we went with it, and I'm super glad that we did. I wrote this song on a Sunday. I didn't even ever think it was going to see the light of day. It was almost one of those songs that you kind of write, you know, get it out and forget about it. I remember I was doing a lot of pop stuff, trying to get like K-pop cuts and stuff like that around that time. So it was very creatively draining, and I just wanted to do something for myself. So I plugged in a guitar, and I just started ripping. And I wrote this probably in like a half an hour, 45 minutes. I did a demo of it, I think, that day probably. And what you're hearing on the actual final track is mostly the demo. But I started out with this riff. And it was just like, it felt good. And so I wrote kind of like a story around it, which I don't normally do either. That's kind of another weird thing for me. I don't normally write like big story songs. But that's exactly what this was. So I hope you guys like it. This is She Likes My Guitar. Those girls. Steel slide on a lonesome night. Or lay on a bed of shaking, baking, ripping while you're sitting beneath a Georgia pine. Oh, she likes the way I play my guitar. Loves them when I slide in and lay it down. Nothing like the way it plays with your heart when you hear that sound. That is, She Likes My Guitar. That was a really just awesome song to be able to put out. So, we rolled with that, I guess, the end of 2018. And then going into 2019, we wanted to come up with something kind of more in line with where I was going musically, and kind of where I continue to go now. And so I've been doing a lot of writing between the time that I actually recorded She Likes My Guitar, which is probably like the summer of 2018, and into the beginning of the new year, trying to find the right song for that and, you know, just something that was a little bit more me, more tomorrow for me. So I came up with this tune called Wake Up, and I produced it here where I'm sitting, and had a guy named Reid Shippen in Nashville mix the song, and it was unbelievable like how much better he made my production sound with that song, because it was a pretty short timeline that I had to work on it and get it done and get it ready. So I think I did it in a few days and really hammered it out and sent it down to Reid, and that would turn out to be the story for a lot of singles that I've done. It's usually, you know, such a fast production timeline for some reason, and then you send it down, and a good mixing engineer really brings it to life. So this was a song that, to me, was just sort of an amalgamation of different stories that I both experienced and you know, heard from friends and stuff like that. Just about kind of reminiscing and maybe wishing that you did something different in the past. So this is Wake Up.
So we can tell.
Single that I released, there's probably like 6 months, 5 or 6 months. I've done a lot of shows, a lot of live stuff, and really focusing on building over there, and just kind of letting Wake Up do its thing with playlists and radio. So I've been doing a lot of writing, going to Nashville, playing shows, like, you know, preparing for kind of that next chapter. And I've written this song called People, and I remember I played it maybe once or twice at kind of just some smaller acoustic things, writer's rounds, whatever. And I never really thought it was like a me kind of song. I always thought it was for somebody else. And I wasn't in love with the way that I constructed the verses of the song. I just really liked the chorus and I thought it was super cool. And I wanted to know what people thought, so I played it a few times. And I was scheduled to write with Owen Barney, who's another Ontario country artist. And I said, hey man, like, I've got this tune called People, kind of love it, kind of don't love it, feels like right up your alley. As an artist, you down to work on it? So I played it for him, we worked on it, we basically reconstructed those verses, wrote them in a way that he could really connect to and that I really knew other people would connect to. They weren't necessarily super personal things to me, but they were definitely things that I've seen others experience and that sort of thing. So we came up with something that we both really, really loved, and it sat for probably like a month or two, and then I texted Owen. I was like, what do you think about People? Like, you know, are you thinking about cutting it? Because my manager, Jeremy, really loves it, and I'm like, we may end up doing something with it. And so anyways, you know, he went back to the label. They had different plans, so I said, okay, well, we're going to cut it. And so I recorded it. Same story as Wake Up, you know, super fast production process. Only this time I had an Ontario-based producer, Jeff Dalziel, do the mixing on it. So he kind of gave it a really Canadian country sort of feel, and I really like the way it feels. We put this out in September, and it's literally just a song about being a person. That's all it is. It's just a song about, you know, that says, hey, you know, it's okay to be you. So this is People. We're the Friday night light shining on us, soaking in the sound of the hometown noise. We're the keys that skipped out the edge of town, found our own kind. Takers, God broken in the heartbreakers. lovers and the haters, the lost and the saviors, leaning on each other, givers and takers, the heartbroken and the heartbreakers. So, after we put out People, we wanted to follow it up pretty quickly. We had some slightly larger release plans with what we wanted to come out with next. A little bit of a bigger radio campaign, and we had a lot of touring scheduled for the end of 2019 into 2020. So we said, let's put something out that just sounds like a friggin' monster of a track. And we'd been going through a lot of pitches right around the same time that I was looking for something for, like, when we decided to do People. So all around that same time, we actually did this song before we did People. Just decided to put it out after. But we've been going through a lot of pitches. I've been doing a ton of writing. And we came across, Jeff Dalziel and I, who produced the song, we came across an old pop song that he'd done with Tyler Shaw and Dave Thomson, and it had kind of sat on the hard drive for a few years. Nobody ever did anything with it because I suppose Tyler was going in a different direction at the time that they'd written it, and so we landed with it, and it was just the perfect song for what we wanted to do, and Dalziel knocked it out of the park in terms of production. Brought in all of, you know, Canada's top players on the track, and it was really, really cool. So that was the first song that I put out that I hadn't had a hand in producing at all. I showed up at the studio, I sang my parts, and that was it. That was my entire involvement in that production, which was refreshing in a lot of ways, nerve-wracking for sure to kind of give up control like that, but I wouldn't do that song in any other way. I think that song was perfectly done, really. So yeah, we took a pop song, turned it into a country track, and this is it. It's called Unscripted.
Yeah!
misery. Unscripted came out, we got some awesome feedback, like from radio and streaming and everything like that, and just everybody listening to it at the shows and things, and we wanted to follow it up pretty quickly. We wanted to come up with something that was going to continue that momentum, keep things pushing forward. We dropped Unscripted at the beginning of January, came out to radio with it at the end of January, and I think we dropped this next single like maybe halfway through March, something like that, like pretty early March. So it was a really quick follow-up to that song, and but what inspired me to put this next song out wasn't so much like what Unscripted was doing or what I'd done in the past. The real inspiration for it was what I was doing on stage, like at the live shows that we'd been doing towards the end of 2019 and into 2020. The energy that we've been getting was phenomenal on every single club stage. I put together, and I'm continuing to constantly put together, looking to 2021 now with the whole virus thing, but constantly putting together a bigger and better show, something that hits you harder and that is more and more engaging. That's kind of always my ongoing goal. So we did that, and Unscripted was pretty down tempo. It was kind of a ballad, so what I wanted to do was put something out that had a little bit more meat on its bones, something that just kind of punched you in the face a little bit harder and feels a little bit more up-tempo. Not like super jumping or anything, but something that played to Unscripted and yet still felt more energetic. One of the songs, I'm going to play a cover right now, because one of the songs that weirdly inspired this release, couldn't tell you why. I mean, the release has nothing to do with this song, but this was always a song I kept coming back to in my head for like looking for things and trying to maybe have like a reference point. And this was the reference point. This is a Slow Hands by Niall Horan.
Slow.
So hands. Listening to this next single that I put out called Love Problem, that I'd selected it based on the idea of slow hands or anything poppy like that that I've been doing at my live shows. I didn't write it with those songs in mind, but just when we were going through songs, I was thinking, like, what's going to kind of tell that sort of story and communicate a similar kind of message in a way that still feels like me. And so we were going through a ton of songs, and I look back on this one that I'd written after a trip down to Nashville in December. We were doing quite a bit of writing down there, but we were hitting the clubs and bars like pretty much every night on that trip. And it just so happened that when we were down there, there were like a ton of other Canadian artists that we knew that were down there at the same time. So like every single night was just another like big Canadian kind of group. And it also just so happened that a lot of our friends down there were going through breakups and were kind of just looking to meet new people and forget about a little bit of heartache for a second. And so I ended up playing Wingman a lot with a few different people, and I just kept thinking to myself, like, this is such a common story, and especially in a town like Nashville where there's like a bar every single step. So I wrote this song on the way back. I came up with it on the flight back, and then I finished it here, but it's called Love Problem. You were sipping a Negroni in the corner of the club, a beautiful mess, so I walked in, said it ain't my business, but I gotta ask why you're here.
Right.
stars to make a hope. But right now, all that I know is that I'm feeling a spark like I've never felt before. Tune and you can hear there's a lot of that story in there, and it's kind of that idea of you being in that position and meeting somebody else in that position. All right, so I've got one more tune that I want to sing for you guys, and this is a cover, but the reason I want to sing it is because all of those songs that I just sang all kind of have a common theme to them, I guess. There's always this underlying inspiration, which is this song I'm about to sing. You know, I think as a writer, as an artist, like all the other writers and artists out there, you know, we get inspired by pretty much everything that we come across, and it makes you want to write differently one day than you do the next, and put something different out and whatever. And that's one of the challenges, I think, as an artist is finding what your kind of home base is. And for me, it's just so simple. It's just this song. Now, of course, I sway in and out from this kind of style and whatever. But when I'm writing, to me, this is like the pinnacle of writing. I always just look at it as a great story, something that everybody can connect with. And to me, it feels like the type of music that I want to make. So it's more of a ballad, I think, than what I normally put out, but that doesn't matter. It's just a great song. So this is Bless the Broken Road by Rascal Flatts. Yeah, I see it out on a narrow way many years ago, hoping I will find you.
Yeah.
rock and roll led me straight to you. God bless the rock and roll led me straight to you. Thank you guys so much for watching and listening, and I've been Dustin Bird. Thank you to Humber College for having me on here and letting me sing some songs for us. So I hope you guys dig those tunes. If you want to check them out, they're all available everywhere that you normally get your songs, and they're all at radio as well. So anyways, I hope to see you guys soon, and feel free to hit me up, DM me, whatever, if you want to chat. Thanks.